Pimlico Sunrise Tour. Okay, sign up for the mystery tour. And I'm good to go. About to begin our tour. Our tour begins. Big place here. Interesting too. That's where you're gonna place your bets.
He said, "I'll put up a track. We'll have a race."
This place opened in 1868.
And the first dinner price.
Well, completed 1870.
The first winner of that race was Preakness. The horse's name was Preakness.
And the first horse to win a race here was named Preakness. That's how this race got the name.
$2,050. So, first it's a little more than that now.
So, we're
going to
make our way to the stakes barn right now where only two horses are actually staying.
This is the second oldest racetrack.
Yesterday,
here Pimlico.
Post positions for the Preakness.
Maybe we'll get lucky and see Nyquist.
Odds are 3-5. Don't bet, and I don't know what that means.
What it looks like. Go ahead. Take them.
He's the blacksmith.
Pass around. These are made of aluminum or aluminum and magnesium or titanium. Hey.
Lucky horseshoes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Right.
Well, if I got one too many.
Back in the box when you're done.
Well, that's not lucky to drop one.
Would you like one?
Here, pass them around.
Hey.
Versus one of the draft shoes when you go around and see the Clydesdales. This is a shoe used for a hobby horse. Coming into the Preakness, now of course there's a quick turnaround. The way we put those shoes on is with nails, and everybody asks if it hurt. It actually doesn't, because if we put them in the right place, that horse's foot is like a fingernail, except quite a bit larger. And that line on the outside, the black and white, is the area that we have to put the nails in. Somehow I lost my big Clydesdale nail. But this is what a medium-sized nail would look like. It has a bevel edge.
One has six and six, 12, and then one just has four and four. Is that just a smaller?
Not well, the way the shoes are different sizes.
Okay.
But rather than most of the shoes that we get now today, we don't have to make for these horses.
Oh.
So what they come in a box. So they're sized differently. It's like the circumference of a circle, less the heels, and they punch nail holes in there so that if one should happen to get displaced and we don't want to put it back in the same place, okay. If the foot's torn, then we...
to the other one.
Then we can go to another nail. All the way up to 9, and the differences are in quarter of an inch increments. And then what we do is, I don't use all this stuff every day to do these horses, but I'll take a stall jack in my toolbox to the stall and shape the shoe, and then try shape the shoe to the bottom of the foot just by using this little portable anvil. It's as simple as, because they come pre-made and you get used to using the same brand all the time, then it's that easy to shape them. And then there are marks on the bottom of the foot that are part of the anatomy that we know where to put those nails, and they come up out of the side of the foot.
Is a turf shoe much different than a regular one?
No.
Next up, the Clydesdales.
They have to have 4 white stockings, and they have to be at least 18 hands, which is about 6 feet tall. And a black mane.
I do travel around with this team year-round with our famous Budweiser Clydesdales. Now, we do travel with 10 horses. We average about 18 hands tall, and each of our horses weighs around 2,000 pounds. These guys will eat about 50 pounds of hay, drink 30 gallons of water every day. Our team travels roughly 45 weeks out of the year, and we are one of three teams that do travel year-round. Our team's based out of Merrimack, New Hampshire. Our West Coast team is Fort Collins, Colorado, and the Midwest, of course, is handled by our St. Louis team. The story with the Clydesdales and Budweiser actually all begins. The first hitch for us was actually a gift to August Bush Sr. from his son, August Jr. on April 7th, 1933. It was delivered this day as a commemorative gift to commemorate the repeal of Prohibition on the same day. So from that day forward, our team has been traveling around the country as ambassadors for Budweiser and even the world.
And now to continue horsing around. What else does one do here? I love horsing around, don't you? This is one huge complex. If you've never been here in person, you're in for a treat. You know you're by the barn. You can smell it. A lot of stalls here. 665. Okay, where's Mr. Ed? Oop, that's not him. A clean horse is a nice horse.
No. So, if you're very...
NBC is here.
...details or numbers, I guess you want to say, you may see that the Kentucky Derby...
All right. Back inside for a bit. One huge complex. Now we're going to place our bets. We've placed our bets onto the winner's circle.
Unfortunately, we can't see the jocks room. It's closed to the public. That's where all the jockeys have their, it's like their lockers, so they have their helmets, their vests, their saddles. So this is the paddock. This is where the horses come and get into their stalls and they get tacked up. And there's actually been a bit of paddock training. Yesterday I saw four horses throughout the day come in and get used to the paddock and back into their stalls. And so,
here's where they prep the horses for the race.
Emma?
Yes?
Nyquist is getting saddled down here on Saturday.
Yes.
Not outside.
Oh, yeah, some trainers, ooh, back out. Like to saddle in here.
Now here's our winner's circle. And the bullfrog will soon be in it. All right.
The winners come.
Your bullfrog is in the winner's circle.
Much bigger. They have everybody come out that has to do with the horse. So they got the trainer's family, the owner's family, the rider, and usually the families are pretty big. And there's some other random people there. You got the interviewer. So here, the weather vane, the horse on top, is shows the Preakness winner from the year previous.
Yeah.
As soon as the winner is declared official, they've already watched the race tapes and have declared no fouls. Somebody goes up and paints the horse immediately. American Paras soaks the blue and yellow. You see the finish line pole is not actually the finish line. If you look to the left, you see that small mirror. There's one of their clothing.
And that's the finish line.
Including their helmet, so they have to have their soaks, their vests, their pants. If you're riding a colt, which is a boy, she weighed in about 20 pounds under what she originally weighed in.
Panting away.
About 145 because at the 19th fence her weight pad had fallen off.
Oh, back in.
You can't get in that one. Oh.
No sunrise yet. Too cloudy out there.
I'm almost there. I'm at the OTTV table.
Thank you.
There goes the tour guide running off.
Hi, guys.
Horse rescue.
I'm glad they give them away.
Minty souvenirs.
Yeah. They can do anything. So what we do is we just take them from the track and
here. Even a gift shop. But I'm sure things cost an arm and a leg here. And I need all my arms and legs right now. Well, got some cool stuff though. And if you're into eating, got that too. Okay, let's place our bets. Oops, already did. And my horse will naturally win. Like that song from the 70s says. Yes, I'm so vain. And there's the odds board, but nothing's being displayed yet. Not for a couple more days yet. Still, interesting place. And of course, if I were to come to the Preakness, this would be my first stop. Getting exercise. Two-way traffic. Three-way traffic. They're anticipating rain for the Preakness, hence the tent in the infield. And down there, the cupola that gets repainted every time the horse wins the Preakness. Showing off. Already NBC is here. Hey, I'm over this way. Get your bullfrog on national TV. Again, puffing and panting. Reminds me of something that the Doors did back in the 60s called Horse Latitudes. Remember that one? Horse Latitudes by the Doors. Legs furiously pumping their stiff green gallop, and heads bob up. I forget the rest of it. Well, didn't forget it, I just don't want to say it. Conquer that track. But of course, as a real fan, I prefer a track of a different kind. Hoping to get lucky. Lady Godiva will come galloping by. waiting for her to come along. Right about now, settle for Mr. Red. A Lady Godiva coming by, just thought of that. Nope, not yet. There's a Preakness horse there, but I forgot his name. Thing is, a lot of these horses look alike, but I can't tell who's who. Well, no. Did I just make a racist statement? And of course, Henry the horse dances the waltz, just as that Beatles song says. So two 60s groups today, The Doors and The Beatles. Henry is still waltzing. And down the stretch it comes. Always wanted to say that. Sure. NBC cameraman there. He'll put us on national TV.
All right, for my own personal use.
There you go. A little self-promotion there. Preakness horse there. LeBron.
Good.
And his trainer. The horse's trainer.
Your camera come Saturday, I heard.
Yeah, as we say, thrown out the anchor.
He's just now leaving the gate.
Another run by there. Or another gallop by. Whatever it's called in horse talk. I'm used to saying run by. I'm a real fan.
Yeah, I don't know.
But he is running.
That's Greg talking to me. He didn't say...
LeBron again, on the right. Henry the horse dancing again. That song was right. Now time for some John Deere. No horses, but got a deer there. Great place to bring the family.
We put other races in it, but no, they're in it. But they're really secondary. They're talking.
I think Nyquist is coming. In the distance, Nyquist. Here comes Nyquist on the right. There's a loose horse there.
This is the worst.
He got loose.
Don't jump it. Now it's time. Actually, they're too close to the phone back up. So then I'll stay on the slip.
Got him. Here comes Terry Wine.
So Mike is turning around. He's going to Dallas.
Jogging towards you. Cantering now. Coming the wrong way.
Another Preakness horse.
Very wide past our set. Coming the wrong way.
Cherry Wine.
Is off the track and on
it. Go.
Coming the wrong way past our set.
Nyquist again on the right. Here you have it, Old Hilltop, another Preakness horse there. Or so I thought. There was once a big hill in the middle of the infield there, but taken down about 100 years ago. That's why this place got its nickname, Old Hilltop. Of course, that hill's long gone. Still, pretty interesting place. Very nice racetrack here. Just saying they're debating on tearing it down and rebuilding it. Or even worse, moving the Preakness to some place in Outer Mongolia instead of here. They can't do that. We might even be on TV. NBC Sports. Your bullfrog on NBC. Watch for me. Your sunrise tour, Pimlico. Hope you enjoyed. And of course, you always know somebody here.
The tours are over. Thank you for coming.
The tours are over.
The tours are over.
They're thanking us for coming. And they're thanking us some more for getting out of here. Before I go, one last gallop by. A 2-fer, a 3-fer, a 5-fer, a 6-fer. That's how I get to the infield. And here's the way out. Your sunrise tour for 2016.